6 years ago, an AI technique looked at footage of video games and then tried to reproduce a playable version of it. It could do something like this. It was blurry, it was super low resolution, and it did not quite understand what it was doing, but still, a great achievement. Then, just 6 months ago, scientists at Google DeepMind made an AI that would look at just a screenshot and would be able to make a very rudimentary platformer game, but a video game nonetheless. And it could even work with your drawings. But today, just 6 months later, a new AI made a huge leap, an actual playable and enjoyable video game. Insanity! Let's have a look. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2 Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai Fehér. So, what quality game could it possibly make? Now, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, because you are looking at it right now. Oh yes, Neural Doom. It works by first starting to play the game, learning how it works, and here is the punchline. Then it learns to remake the game itself. Note that we usually don't do this, but at places, the footage might be a little more explicit than usual. Now, this is a diffusion-based model, so similar to the ones that take a piece of noise and create an image or video for you from it. And it can finally make a pleasant, playable version of the game. Yes, actual humans are playing the game here and in real time. Entirely made by the AI, of course, after having played it itself. So good! So, our question is, how good is it really? And how do we find out how good it is? Well, get a bunch of humans in the room, show them the simulation and the real game, and ask them which is which. Can they tell? What do you think? Well, yes they can. But only a little better than chance. That is an unbelievable jump in quality. I mean, just look at this. This was an amazing result 6 years ago, and today, just a couple more papers down the line, we get this. Loving it! They call this technique Game Engine and give us the recipe to potentially learn other games too, all this knowledge, free of charge. Now, limitations. This still requires expensive hardware that is not commercially available, which means that this is not something we are going to be doing at home on our own desktop PCs. Yet. The other is that it only has 3 seconds of memory, it does not remember more. But, get this, interestingly, by making sense of the visual cues in the game, it can still remember what we did for longer time horizons. However, it is not perfect. It still forgets. And I think this is going to open up a whole new world of game development. It could become less costly and more available for all of us. What a time to be alive! So, what do you think? What would you fellow scholars use this for? Let me know in the comments below. If you're looking for an NVIDIA GPU cloud service for large-scale AI projects, check out One-Click Clusters by Lambda, featuring up to 512 NVIDIA H100 GPUs with InfiniBand networking. And hold on to your papers, because with One-Click Clusters, you can access all these GPUs on demand, with reservations starting at just 2 weeks. Try it out at lambdalabs.com/paper or click the link in the description.